ladies and gentlemen, and little monsters of all ages, please give a rowdy and ruckus round of applause for Krazy Kirk and the Hillbillies.
Before the show. My tuner's not wherever it is. Hold on, y'all, stay with me. Good grief. Eric, can you hear the guitar? Am I close enough? Playing the mandolin, the fiddle, and the electric guitar, Eric Brenton. Playing the drums, Brad Conyers. Playing the doghouse bass and the electric bass, Andrew Swanson. Playing the five-string banjo and the electric Telecaster guitar, Rick Dunham. And now, let's do the summertime blues.
To try to get a date, my boss says,
"No, that's son, you gotta work late."
Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do.
There ain't no cure for the summertime blues.
Yeah. Ow! Well, my mama bought me from the soon we gotta earn some money. If you wanna use a car to go
too young to vote.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do. There ain't no cure for the summertime blues.
Bunch of kids here. I'm liking this kid thing going on. We got lots of kids, and I hope to see them here at 4 o'clock, because that's when we do our cavalcade. We have a big old parade that goes around this whole thing. It's a short, cute little show, so I hope that y'all come around and see it at 4 o'clock and join the other goblins, witches, and spooks, and all sorts of characters that you just might see. I think we might have a couple of scarecrows out here as well. We got the mayor here. Calico Kate will be here, so make sure you come and bring your children and join in with us. And we got a fiddle player over here. He's got a fiddle ready to go on a fiddle song. It's a Celtic song. It's got that Irish Scottish influence to it. It's called the Blackberry Blossom. You know, every time you play that, I have to go into the little dance. I don't use my arms. And then all of a sudden, Michael Flatley comes around, and all of a sudden we're using our arms, and it's wrong. It's wrong, I tell you, it's wrong.
Thank you.
And this is a great song. It should not be renamed. It's called the Blackberry Blossom, but let's call it the Boysenberry Blossom. Friends, and I'm lucky that I get to work with the best players in California, and they are absolutely my best friends, and we get along completely on every issue except politics. See, even though he was trying to cover up the word politics, we do not agree on politics or religion. That's the truth. And sometimes we've had a few arguments that have happened here and there. And now we got the midterms coming up, so who knows what that's going to entail. But it seems like every 4 years, we get to this huge, horrible argument about peanut butter.
Oh.
And it's mostly, I want to say, you know, I know Brad Conyers is politically in the center, but when it comes to this peanut butter, he's
creamy.
See, he's
maniacal, actually. He's not moderate by any means. He's what I would call maniacal.
Yeah, creamy. I just prefer creamy.
He prefers that everybody like... He doesn't like... He told me that he thinks people that like crunchy peanut butter are stupid.
I did not.
Yeah, you didn't put it that way.
I said think that's they're just eating unfinished peanut butter.
I'm angry. Halloween, and I know that it's a little too much for some people. I mean, we've gotten some complaints, some letters, angry people about it, but we're going to keep doing it anyway. We're happy that we get to be on this stage. This is you have to be really good to play on this stage, and Thomasina wasn't available, so we got to be here on this. And now we shall present the Prince of Darkness, Ozzy Osbourne.
Thank you.
calling you out or anything, but some people look like they were being judgmental. But maybe they just had heat stroke too, you know, you never know. Uh-huh. No, we're just kidding. Of course we're kidding. We there's no level that we won't stoop to in order to entertain the audience, and that was no exception. And now, let's do Jenny. To a minor key on the happiest fiddle song in the world. It's the Orange Blossom Special. Thank you.
best to follow, Matt. That's hard to follow. He's fantastic. What a great fiddle player. I have a long story that's all about my growth as a fiddle player. I started out very poor at what I did. I'd never seen a fiddle. I didn't know what to do with my fiddle. And then I had a fiddle one day, and I said, how am I going to play this thing? And then, you know what? Enough of the story. Let me just give you an example of what it sounded like when I played fiddle. But first, I need to check my tuning on your head real quick. It's fine, thank you. It's always good to check, you know, that heat and all of a sudden it's changing the instruments and a little tuning problems, but we're somehow got lucky with the fiddle. Anyway, let's move on. Sound like this when I first played the fiddle. Mozart of the Ozark. I don't get it. Over my head anyway. So they are my friends, my brothers at the time. That's back when we were brothers. We were brothers years ago, but then it got just kind of weird, so now we're just friends. This is how these teeth have improved my fiddling technique. Make sure y'all come out at 4 o'clock and see the cavalcade, alright? Alright, here we go. You know, I'm affecting this guy right here. This guy wasn't moving at all. Watch me get him to move. Watch this. Watch him. It's a gift I sneak up on the cow, then I plant myself softly, like this. It's a little not that soft. Hopefully we didn't scare the cow away. Then I take out my cattle driving whip, and I go, then the cow goes, that was cussing the cow. Sorry about that, y'all. But that cow still won't go. We call the cops. Requesting backup. Requesting European cop car. That don't work, we sing Rawhide. Help me, everybody, sing with me, sing. Ah!
raucous round of applause for Krazy Kirk and the Hillbillies.